Hi, my name is Cliff Beatty. I'm with Bard Manufacturing, and this is the Breathe Easy series of videos. Today, I'm going to show you a FUSION-TEC installation. After unwrapping your new FUSION-TEC product, visually inspect all the panels of the unit to make sure there is no shipping damage. Also, make sure to inspect the top of the unit to verify that there's no shipping damage to the top. The first thing that you'll notice about the FUSION-TEC is that the wall openings match our current large cabinet wall mount openings of today. Even though it's a counterflow reverse airflow unit, the wall openings will match your current openings if you're removing an existing wall mount product. Another thing to note is that the top ring flashing is attached to the back of the unit. You're going to want to remove this, remove the screws. This hook bend will attach to the top of the unit on this back lip. So you're going to want to remove that, put this up underneath that lip, and then you're going to want to put a liberal amount of caulk all the way around the flanges on the back of the unit before mounting it to the wall. It's important to remember to remove the filter access door so that you can access these three screw holes in the back flange of the unit. To remove the filter access door, remove these three screws and just simply open up the door at a 45 degree angle and lift up. The FUSION-TEC unit is equipped with a dirty filter indicator. On the FUSION-TEC product, on the right side of the unit is a cover for access to the service ports. Remove the top 5/16 screw and the bottom 5/16 screw and gently remove the cover. Remember to check service pressures for the unit. Please refer to the user guide and access that information through the LV controller. To remove the front door, you will take out these 5/16 screws on this panel. Once all the screws are removed from the perimeter of the front door, lift up on the front door. And inside the control panel area, you'll find your installation instructions. Make sure to save these for future use. You'll notice that there's a wire channel at the bottom of the control panel for field wiring. You'll notice that there are electrical entrances in both sides of the unit. And these are for your high voltage wire connections and for your communication wire. Communication wire will attach to this terminal block on this side. High voltage wire will connect to this side into the circuit breaker. Remember, if you're using a 230 volt or a 208 volt unit, to make sure that the proper taps are selected on the low voltage transformer. Each FUSION-TEC unit requires an individual address in the logic board. Plug into the logic board using the TEC-I controller. Give each unit an individual address and you'll be ready to go. Another thing to remember is that each unit can run in orphan mode until you get the controller set up and operating. Remember when installing the FUSION-TEC products that the LV controller can be put anywhere inside the building. The temperature sensor should be put 5 to 6 foot from floor level, either in between the units or on the sidewall of the structure. That concludes the Bard Breathe Easy FUSION-TEC installation guide.